Oh my God.
Donal's already feeling the ill effects of the jungle.
I'm just a bit worried with my eye at the moment.
How are you doing, Donal?
Hiya! Come here. I want you to have a look at my eye.
You've been bitten.
Have I been bitten, yeah?
Yeah.
It's not sore, it's not infected, it's not, it doesn't feel sore.
It'll go down and it should go down within a day. If it's not sore, I wouldn't take anything.
Yeah. So this is the way our feet greet the morning here. Bloody hell. They're upside down, by the way.
At least the torrential rain means that getting enough water won't be a problem.
That's as fresh as you'll get.
Well, if you didn't laugh, you would cry.
Having set up Donal's camp, Chris will move to his own site deeper in the jungle.
There's Chris over there. He's about to leave. And I shall miss him. I shall miss my guru, my sensei, the master, the godfather of the jungle. How do you feel about leaving?
Despite the banter, Donal is apprehensive about Chris's departure.
Right, mate, watch what you're doing. Okay?
I will do. Miss you. Miss you.
Yeah. I'll see you in 4 days' time. Okay?
See ya.
Right, see you later. You take care, mate.
Okay. Oh, well. I'm on my own now. I have to talk to myself. I wonder how I'm going to cope without him. My priorities are now, I've got to get some food inside me. I have a plan. I'm going straight for the palm heart. No nonsense. Come on.
But getting to the palm means entering monkey territory.
You can hear the howler monkeys going mad. Hello. Hello. Oh, I better make a run for it. Chuck something down on me. Ah. He thinks the howler monkey doesn't like me. So this is the palm I've spotted. And I think if I knock it down, it won't be stopped by anything else in the forest.
The manacle palm is a valuable source of nutrition, but the edible heart is hidden at the top of the tree.
I'm genuinely worried about chopping off my fingers. I mean, I'm bad with a knife and fork, let alone a machete. That would be down in maybe a year's time.
After over half an hour of chopping, Donal has nothing to show for his efforts. Food remains elusive. 7 miles upriver, Chris Ryan arrives at his new campsite. It's the first time he'll have to survive alone in the jungle.
The area's very different to the other location. First thing I noticed was it's heaving with mosquitoes. The proximity of the river. One of the most important things to do when you're establishing camp is to do a 360 and walk right round the whole place. You can see how much water we had. This is just all mud and everything is dank and just pretty miserable. Plus the fact it's not a great deal of palm down here. So there's nothing here, it's pretty poor.
Surrounded by flood water and without food sources, Chris is forced to adopt a new strategy.
If this is going to be the pattern, I'll be going into survival mode, which will be minimum amount of work.
Despite his failure with the palm, Donal has decided on a strategy of his own.
This is my emergency rations, and I'm determined to come in and survive or starve on the fruits of this jungle here. And I'd consider it a defeat if I succumbed to this farreen.
Finding food will be a struggle, but there's one resource here that's never in short supply.
Oh my God! Look at that, unbelievable. It's nearly full, and it's less than 2 minutes since I put it out there. Unbelievable. It's all about being wet here.
Just hours after Chris's departure, Donal's morale and his physical condition are deteriorating.
It's 38 hours since I've had any food, not that I'm counting, and it's very strange, the effect. You do notice all your mental faculties slipping away, and I keep dropping things, I keep losing things. There's no doubt my mental faculties are crumbling a little bit under the pressure.
I have noticed my focus has deteriorated. I've got no energy. I'm expending energy chopping, walking, and just surviving in this climate. And I don't know how long I'll last.
We're trying to make a fire. It's unbelievably hot. Everything is soaking wet. I've nearly lost this about five times. I can't tell you the emotions that go through your body when you put the effort in and you're getting it and you think you've got it and then it just starts to die. I'll tell you, it's unbelievable. I'm not sure I can remember when I've relied or I've needed fire so much or wanted it to burn so much.
As well as being key to physical survival, maintaining a fire requires focus and discipline, which are critical in winning the psychological battle.
This is the second day without food, and I can tell you I'm lightheaded. I'm very tired. I can feel my heart rate's up, my pulse is banging away. What would be minimal effort is taking quite a bit of effort, and I can say probably this is the hardest I've worked for a long time.